Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Big Yak Monthly Cup again. Today is going to be a very special edition because today is going to be the monthly final of the month of August, which means we have a different format today and, in comparison to the previous months, not 100 players or like 100 plus players. We're only going to have 20 players. So basically the top 20 players of the month managed to qualify for this tournament and they will be battling it out against each other for some juicy prizes today, sponsored by Volvic and also by Big, worth around 400 euro. And to make it exciting, we have a special format today, which is basically going to be a custom knockout mode, where each player has 3 lives. So not a normal knockout mode, where, you know, when you're in the red area once, you are knocked out. Actually, you will only lose a life now, and you have 3 in total. That will make it not only less random and more fair, it will also make it more exciting overall. But of course, the character of the Big Yak Monthly Cup is still going to be the same. We're still going to be using random maps, we're still going to be using not necessarily high quality maps. It's gonna be very, very cool. All participants are on the server. The way it's gonna work now though, we have 15 maps and all 15 of these maps will be played. Each single map is gonna have one warm-up where people can check out the map and learn it. And then we're gonna have 2 live rounds. That's basically how it's gonna work. So only very short warm-up and only, 2 rounds per map, so then we're gonna have quite a lot of map switches to make it, like, to keep it exciting, basically. The very interesting thing is, of course, the knockout repetition, because as I said, we're gonna have 15 maps overall. On the first 5 maps, so map 1 to 5, the bottom 3 people of each round will lose 1 life. On map 6 to 10, the bottom 2 people of each round will lose a life. And on the final 5 maps, only the last player in each round will lose a life. Might sound a little bit complicated, but we also have a special UI, which is always telling you guys how many players are going to be knocked out in this round, or like how many people are going to lose a life. So everything should be clear. You will always be able to see that in the top left here. That should show everything. And this is the first map here. I think this one was actually... I did check the maps earlier to make sure that the maps are not going to be dog shit. So I filtered out very short maps and also way too difficult maps. And yeah, I would say we're going to hop straight in. Very first map of the day, very first round. Let's hop straight in and let's see who's going to be the first players to lose a life. So as we are on map 1, 3 players will lose a life, as you can see over here. You can also see it here. And we have this very cool UI on the left. So you can also always see the red area here. So you can see that 3 players are going to lose a life this round. And you can also see the lives of each player all the time. Furthermore, I can also just click on the players to spectate them. So it will be a bit less chaotic to, you know, to spectate. And with that, we can always just click on the... I tapped out. Yik. We can always just click on the bottom players to see how they are performing. And, you know, if they could possibly do a snipe. So... couldn't really focus on the map yet, but people are somewhat surviving here. Fredwolf is getting out of the red zone. Hagen is still in it, same for Pöppe. Hagen is actually completely in the mud. That is not very good. Let's see maybe if Bleff can make a comeback. I think Hagen missed a checkpoint. No, Hagen is actually in right now. And Hagen, oh, Hagen barely surviving. Okay, I think Pöppe or Torben respawned. Absolutely, XTD. And Elkon says he knows this map. Yeah, that can of course happen. Like, when you play a lot of random maps on Trackmania Exchange, you could potentially have a map in here that people know already. That's just lucky for Elkon then. Not like Elkon already was a you know, one of the top players in here, but yeah. Interesting though. Okay, so let's see what we have on the map. We start with a water pool. Then a bit of dirt to dry the tires. We have a drift to the right, drift to the left. Okay, quite doable. We have a transition into the grass and Bleff hitting the tree, saving it somewhat nicely though. And then we have a long right turn, long left turn, a drift actually. I would say rather normal map. I can tell you there's definitely worse maps coming up than this one. I think here people can do an air brake to get a reactor soup. Yeah, look at that. Dawnstar had so much speed. Techie with a respawn. Bleff actually with a DNF. That is something you should never do in this format. Because DNF basically means you will lose a life. So shouldn't do that. And we have Seamouse currently on the first red. Can Seamouse snipe anyone? Maybe Salmon. But the ending of the map is very simple. I don't think anything is going to happen here. Nope, it is actually Seamouse losing his first life. And Torben and Bleff losing their second life already. So they are already down to 1 life only, which means if they are in the red area once more, they are in the mud. They could literally be knocked out on map 1 out of 15. Let's see though. I hope they're not going to be knocked out. That would have been very unexpected to see a knockout on the very first map already out of 15. So let's see. Torben and Bleff are the ones to watch out for. Seamouse with a bit of airtime here. Not looking too great, but oh, Elkon with a slowdown. Elkon knowing the map. But surely he also knows how to come back now, right? We will see. Seamouse looking quite juicy. Torben is fighting. He is on the edge. Wow. Overtaking. Does he know about the airbrake? No, he does not. I don't think anybody will crash here. My name is Bleff, and I'm probably knocked out of... Yeah, hello? Okay, we have the first knockout. It is Bleff knocking out himself. Understandable. Have a good rest of the evening, my friend. But yeah, Torben at least survived. Torben is a survivor. And is it actually... Ain't no way. Elkon lost his first life. And that is exactly why I didn't put Elkon that high up in the predictions. Because... Because Elkon's of course really strong, but I feel like Elkon is also the type of guy to randomly lose a life in like easy rounds, you know? So yeah, we'll see. Elkon down to 2 lives. That doesn't have to mean anything, but it's of course not good, obviously. But yeah, interesting. And the maps are not known, no. People don't know. Like, this is the first time they are on this map here now. They don't know. They have 30 seconds to learn it. Some maps are even longer than 30 seconds, so they cannot even check out the entire map in the warm-up. And that's basically it. That wasn't a rage quit. Like, he full bonked, he would have been out either way. He just, like, left earlier, basically. It was not a rage quit. So it seems like we have a mini tech map here that should favor certain players. For example, Scrappy should be really good at this. And in general, everybody who's, like, good at normal driving. So it could be maybe dangerous for people like Techie. I don't know. Techie, really good player, of course. But not necessarily playing, like, tech maps. So let's see about this. Chem 7 is enabled. People can do Chem 7 if they want to. So let's see, Torben. Torben, the star of the show. He needs to not get bottom 3 here. Otherwise, he will be out of the tournament already. Oh, very close fight here. Oh, Torben almost catching a nose slide. Not with the best line. No, Torben. Is he out? No, he's in. Okay, Torben, all good. But we have Seamouse. Seamouse full bonked. And actually losing his second life already. Damn Seamouse, eh. That is a bit unexpected. And Scrappy said he had this map in his challenge today. Ain't no way. Like, for those of you that don't know, Scrappy and Lars are doing a challenge right now where they, you know, battle against each other on random maps of certain styles. And I guess today the style was like tech maps or something, and he played this exact map. Yeah, okay. I mean, as I said, like, it helps a lot when you play a lot of these random maps. It just increases the odds that you might know it already. Oh, Torben! No! Holy shit. And that is Giuliano and Marinci losing their first life. Pupbear losing his second life. And Torben on the fucking edge, man. And now we have a hard map. As I said, I played every single map exactly once. Just to see if it's not too difficult. Because that would ruin the entire knockout things, booms. And yeah, this is a map by Ski Freak and by Mime. And that is gonna make stuff really hard. Let's take a look at... Let's not take a look at Lars. Let's take a look at Scrappy. Lars apparently going into Chem 7. I think that's a very smart idea because 30 seconds warm-up is not a lot here. And this is a 1 minute difficult mixed map. Like, people are gonna crash. People are, like... Ah! Like, as long as you survive, you will not lose a life on this map. Or at least in the first out of 2 rounds. So let's see. Absolute banger map here. Competitive mixed map by 2 really good players. And people only had 30 seconds to take a look at it. This is gonna be fun. Let's see. So, who do we follow though? There's still quite a few people in with 3 lives. Who were not in the bottom yet. Scrappy is one of them. So let's maybe just follow Scrappy. Let's see what he's gonna cook. Start is looking fine. Let's just maybe follow the first place throughout the entire round. Then through the triangle here, people saw that correctly. People are losing gears, but honestly, that doesn't matter at all. You see the gaps are already 5 seconds-ish. Then we have this. We have a left turn. Scrappy going for some water. Not the correct path, but also not bad, to be honest. Like, he survived. That's the main thing. Then we have a plastic wall ride going down here. Through another triangle. That seems to be the theme of the map here, going through the triangles of checkpoints. Then inside pole here, back to the dirt. Uphill right turn into a sharp left turn. A lot of touches here. Scandia is still alive, actually. Then we have a bobsleigh transition into roads. No, into plastic. I don't even understand what's happening. And then we have a right turn, right slide. And I think that should be the finish. Yes, risky finish as well. People are going for it. Quite an easy risky finish. But yeah, very dank. So, who do we have on orange? Or like, on the first red? It is actually Pupbear. Wait, Pupbear. He needs to snipe one. I think it's over. Pupbear is knocked out. Okay, that is crazy. Pupbear on second last position. That is unexpected, to be honest. Damn, Puppy. I was thinking about putting him into my top 5 prediction. Crazy. And now he got 20th. Okay, that was unexpected, though. Who made the overlay? Yeah, this entire script and overlay. This is basically a vanilla Nadeo overlay. Like, not really a custom one. But this entire mode was made by Bö. He's also always helping Big with the other Volvic tournaments. But he's getting also paid for that by Big. By, you know, so he didn't just do it for fun. But he definitely cooked, so he deserves it. Really good overlay. Everything works now also. We had some issues yesterday, but he fixed everything super rapidly. So yeah, everything is fine. And I think, like, it does, like, he could have also made, like, custom branded overlays where everything would have been, like, white or, you know, Volvic colors, super dank. But we just decided to go for the vanilla one because I think this one looks absolutely fine. And yeah, so shoutouts to Bur as well. So, what do we have here? Giuliano, currently fighting for his life here on this track. Nobody with one life is in danger right now. So Seemaus is looking fine. Torben as well, still fighting. And we have Kanchika in the bottom positions. Kanchika, Hagen is ahead. What will happen here? Can Kanchika snipe someone? The finish is already coming up. Maybe somebody misses the finish? Nope, that is the first life lost for Kanchika. Damn. Close round though. Pretty, pretty close. And we, in the meantime, we go to the second map, which is called Maraisia Rally. And this is a map not many people will like, because this is a rally ice map. This is a rice map. We have a rally ice map, guys. So yeah, good luck, have fun. Rally ice is also in the tournament. But this is how it looks like. We still have quite a few players with 3 lives, and also quite a few with 2. And also, you know, 4 people with only 1 life left. So the field is quite mixed. So yeah, very dank map. I did one warm-up on this. Like, I saw it, I randomized it. I was like, oh my god, people are gonna hate this. I did one warm-up, was like, yeah, map is doable. Zack, and now we are here. So let's see. Rally Ice, of course, a very unique surface. And I'm pretty sure not many people are really aware. Like, I think every player knows how this works technically, but not many people are like experienced in this. So that's gonna be very, very fun here. Nein! Oh my god. The thing is, I'm sometimes tapping out because the Volvic logo has a link that you can click on to the Volvic website. And if I'm too far down on it, I open the website. Okay, Seemaus. Seemaus and Flonko in danger. Oh, Flonko didn't make the speed check. Seemaus? I think Flonko is in the mud, but Seemaus. Torben is here as well. No, what is this? What is this? Oh my god, Seemaus got it so good. I think Seemaus is safe. What about Torben? Torben needs to catch one player. One player. Techie with the crash. Seemaus with no speed. Can Torben catch one? There is a risky finish on the left. He's not going for it. No, Torben! No, what is happening? No, Torben's out. Torben and Flonko knocked out, actually. Yeah, there is a risky finish here. If you follow the path, you can get the reactor and take the risky finish. It's actually not hard to do. It is not hard to do. Ah, that's unlucky, man. No, Torben and Flonko out. We lost 2 German gamers. GG to them, though. Torben and Flonko in the mud. And Elkon just saying ban rice. Yeah, but he survived. I can tell you this is not the very last altered map of today. There is gonna be one more. And I can also tell you that one is, yeah, not better. You can already look forward to that. Oh my god. Pains, yeah, there's gonna be pain, indeed. And Khan, thank you very much for the 9-month free sub, appreciate it. So next round, Salmon. Didn't see a lot of Salmon yet. He also lost a life already. I must have missed that. And I think Salmon is actually quite good at rally ice or stuff like this. So he should be able to overtake people. Oh, really good nose slide here by Salmon. Can he make the transition? Yes, looks good. He needs to catch one more, I think. At least one more. Yep, also slowing down for this turn, not crashing the wall like many others. That is a good idea. We also have Seamouse. Seamouse fighting for his life again. Does he know about the Risky? He knows about it. So many people don't. The Risky is super easy. Look, it's not hard and it is faster. And it is actually Salmon? No, what is happening? Finish? Okay, Dawnstar, Salmon, and Dennis losing a life. Actually, very interesting that Dawn... No, yeah. Yeah, Dawnstar, Salmon, and Dennis. Very interesting that Dawnstar only lost a life now, because he actually qualified as 20th/21st. So he barely made it in. But yeah, it worked out. And so far, he's doing really good. And we're on the next map in the meantime. This one looks maybe quite simple and cool, but I struggled a lot with this one. I struggled a lot with this map when I did one attempt. As you can see, I needed 103 to make it. Because this map has a few speed checks. And I'm pretty sure we're also going to see the one or other player dying to that. So let's maybe spectate Techie. So the jump that I was struggling with is this one here. I don't know why, but this one was kind of tricky. But seems like people actually got it. Never mind, we have Seamouse at the start. Okay, Seamouse is so in the mud. Kanchika also not having the speed that you would usually want to have here. And we have Nuclear fighting for his life. Nuclear needs to catch one more player. Never mind, he doesn't. Because Marius failed. The Safemeister is in the mud. Safemeister didn't save. Okay, what is this? Oh, we have mistakes though. We have mistakes. Marius is currently in. He's also sniping Hagen. No, it's Salmon. Salmon is in the mud. Yeah, they would need to catch two. That's not gonna happen. No, people are in the finish. We're losing another two players here, guys. Salmon and Seamouse. This was map 5, though. Or is map 5. So we're only gonna have one more round where the bottom three will lose a life. And then we will shift over to map 6, where we will then only have the bottom two losing a life. So it's gonna get a bit more exciting. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Final round. Will people die on the start again? Haken had some issues. What? Oh, Mareintje! Okay, Mareintje pulling a Dutchie. Seamouse did the same and it's also Scrappy. Scrappy with the full bonk and he has zero speed. Basically pulling the Kanchika. So they are fully out of the race. Skandir in danger for losing his first life. Skandir is, by the way, the one who I predicted to win this cup. So far, that prediction is living up. But he already overtook Techie. Wait, why is it only bottom 2 losing a life, John C? It's already bottom 2, 3 rounds at start seems to confuse it a little. Yeah. Okay, the UI could be wrong though. It could be possible that Techie also loses a life. I'm not sure. But that was the issue because we started with 21 players instead of 20 because of this, you know, the issue that I explained earlier. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, is anybody hyped for some altered Nadeo? Trackmania Nations ESWC F7 1 down. Quality mapping. Quality mapping, ladies and gentlemen. So this is a map from Trackmania Nations ESWC, the very first stadium game of Trackmania, which was released in 2006. So it's a remake of that map in this game together with altered Nadeo, where the finish is one block down, which doesn't really change the map a lot, but I don't know, it's still funny. But yeah, very most normal random Trackmania map. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Oh, Dennis trying a Neo slide, not really working out here. And then we can do a cut here where you jump to the right and skip the quarter pipe jump. Not sure if it's smart to go for it though, because you will have less exit speed. You see, some people are 3 seconds ish ahead. And it actually seems like the cut is faster. Some people are a little bit ahead, but it's not a lot though. Alright, so bottom two lose a life. Dennis. Dennis the Menace. Wait, where's Nuclear? Oh no, it's Dennis and Fredwolf. Will somebody fail the wallbang? Everybody wallbanging. Everybody dropping into the finish. Dennis hitting it. But Dennis is out. And Giuliano. Almost sniping Marius. Marius in orange, basically. And yeah, it is actually Dennis being knocked out. That is very unlucky. Super sorry to Dennis. GG though, 15th place is quite solid. Thanks for playing. So let's see if the cut is actually faster, because I really don't know. Technically it should be, but you need to do it quite nicely for it to work, you know? So personally, I would not do it just to, like, you know, make it safe. You don't need it to get into the... to avoid the bottom three, basically. So, Kanchika is doing it, but as you can see, Kanchika has way less speed now. And he's not making this jump, and it seems like Kanchika actually loses out on a lot because of that. Okay, the cut is actually slower, and Kanchika is most likely gonna lose a life because of that. Because after this, the map is super simple. I think he got one behind him, but I think he's in the mud. Yep, Kanchika is actually gonna be out, unless somebody fails to finish. Oh, so close though. No way, Kanchika is already out. Kanchika on 14th. And the thing is, I can tell you, we got full speed maps coming up. Not one, but was there two? I'm not sure. At least one full speed map is coming up. And he didn't even make it until there. Oh, that's actually so sad for Kanchika. GG though, nonetheless. Good timing, because we are in the middle of the monthly final of the Big Yak Monthly Cup of August. And we have some crazy gamers battling it out against each other. Wizzy, next month you also have to qualify. Go, keep cooking. Any spammy of the day in the map pack? Not this time, no. I can tell you that. No spammy of the day. Oh, Hagen, no speed. Same for Purple. Purple having a bit more, but they both need to rely on catching one. Purple overtaking. Is there a crash in the finish? There is a risky finish here. Is Purple aware? Purple is hitting the things. No, what is happening? No, everybody's failing it. You can just jump. No, guys, you can just jump through the hole. And Marius loses his first life. Oh my god. Okay, that risky finish caught many people off guard. That was super chaotic. Holy moly. Marijntje sadly is out. We are losing another Dutchie. Did we lose all Dutchies already? Yeah, we lost Seemaus, Dennis and Marijntje. The triple Dutchies are out already. Damn, that is unlucky. GG Marijntje though. Well, this was really mean to be honest. But I mean, that's also it was also kind of funny. All Germans out? What do you mean all Germans out? We still got the extra Germans. I mean, the Dutchies are also kind of German, yeah. But we still got some other Germans. For example, Strappy, Lars, Marius, Giuliano, Hagen as well, Purple. We got some Dutchies. Germies. What? Germans. So, what is happening in the next round here? It is Hagen overtaking Purple now. Does he know about the risky finish? Hagen jumping! Hagen! Nein! But so many people are respawning. Who is even in? Who is out? Giuliano? Nein, guys, what do you know? Giuliano survived. Oh my god, and Hagen is out. Okay, people really had struggled with that risky finish. And ladies and gentlemen, winter 2021, map 19, Desert Reactor down. Banger. Banger map. Desert Car Reactor down on an old Nadeo map. That's what I want to see in this tournament. I hope people are ready for this. When I randomized this and I saw it, I had the exact same thought as on the ready ice map. I was like, holy shit, people are gonna hate it. Fucking amazing. The thing is, you are so fast and the car also still slides out. And you also have ice here. Like, look how fast people go. It looks like reverse Riolu. Like 2x game speed. Absolutely amazing. Banger map. So people most likely know this map, unless they are like new to the game. But yeah. It's not, yeah, I mean, Desert Reactor down, that's all I can say. But I mean, guys, we're playing the Big Yak Monthly Cup. If you expect competitive mix maps here, then you're clearly playing the wrong tournament. Easy as that. So let's see, Giuliano, as a keyboard player, is struggling a little bit. Doing the ice slides, surviving quite nicely. Oh, full bonk! Oi, 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 oi. But he is out of the danger zone, but Scrappy therefore is in it. What is that? Okay, I think Scrappy is gonna lose his second life here. In the meantime, Fredwolf battling with Giuliano. Can Fredwolf snipe? Oh, going for a drift and overtaking! What a move by Fredwolf! Wait, but they overtook Purple. Giuliano sniped back. But it's Purple in the mud. Yeah, hello? And Scrappy losing his second life. Damn. As you can see, quite a few people with one life now. So stuff is dangerous. But we still have Lars and Skandir at least with three lives. They might be the only one, though. Not sure. But yeah, very dangerous. No, Techie also has three, so. Yeah, very competitive here. Scrappy now surviving. Scrappy going for a good ice slide. Going for a drift. Yeah, like for the slide out, rather. Purple fully in the mud. Who is in second last? It is... actually, Marius. Marius, as someone who is good with the desert car. Oh, but sniping Lars and sniping everybody and crashing and what is happening? But he's safe, I think. Who's out? Oh, and Lars barely keeping his three lives together. Holy moly, eh. It is actually Purple and Fred Wolf losing their second one. So they will go down to one life already. And now, I hope you guys are ready. Kanchika, type 57 in the chat. It is a banger of a full speed map. And this is actually quite a difficult one. I can tell you that much. It's 1 minute long and really not that easy to even survive. So, yeah. Let's watch Elcon maybe. This one has a lot of speed sliding, but also a lot of like wall riding and shit like that. So, yeah, quite a dank map, but also like high quality full speed. It's not a bad one. It's not a bad one. And it should also be not too hard to survive for these players. So it's actually only Techie, Skandir, and Lars still being in with 3 lives. I mean, Skandir and Lars expected, but Techie actually, Techie cooking. Not bad. Techie actually a gamer. So yeah, everybody survived the start until here. That is very nice. We have no victims yet to the map. Mario's a bit slow, so we can see the field from his POV. Oh, we have a full bonk by Dawnstar, and I think Techie crashed as well. But let's first of all see the rest of the map. So we have this, then we go down, and then up here again. We saw another respawn, there we are! Oi, 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 oi! Mario's clipping! Mario's still surviving! We still have speed checks on the map. I didn't check if the maps are respawnable, by the way. I just hope they are. Then we have a wall ride into... yeah. Dank shit. Purple coming in with a lot of speed. Mario's still alive though. Really slow, but he is barely making the speed checks. And there's the finish. So yeah, map is not too hard overall. It is quite doable. I think Nuclear is in the mud. Dawnstar is gonna finish though. Techie also finishing. So I think, yeah, Scrappy in the mud. Out in 11th. And we also have Nuclear being out. Damn. So Scrappy in 11th place. Nuclear finishing in 10th. Alright. GG. Yeah, Nuclear, I think, got fucked up by the speed once and couldn't keep it anymore. Unrespawnable FS map? Yeah, I didn't check that, to be fair. I didn't check that. And Dawnstar barely surviving, eh? Did he finish? Yeah. Holy moly, eh. And we're already down to 9 players. So more than half of the gamers have been knocked out. Wait, what did people say? This will go onto my CV that I beat Scrappy. Same, 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 same. Okay, it's kind of funny. Okay, so we still have Lars, Skandir, and Techie with 3 lives being in. That is crazy. They are cooking, eh? Holy shit. Actually cooking. Alright, so what's gonna come up next? Hop. Hop. Alright. Yeah, nobody dead yet. Mario's again quite slow, but also Lars and Dawnstar not with the greatest speed. Oh, I think Fredwolf caught some airtime there. That is, of course, not good. And now Dawnstar with less speed. Marius could catch up again. Dawnstar is down to 1 life already. Marius going for a very safe jump. Dawnstar, more speed. Dawnstar needs to snipe Fredwolf if he wants to survive. It's gonna be Fredwolf. What? Fred? No. Dawnstar sniping Fredwolf here now. Can he keep his lead though? Can he keep his lead? Oh, Fredwolf with more speed. Who's gonna be out of the tournament? It's gonna be Fredwolf. Holy shit. By 500. Jesus Christ. And yeah, I said Fredstar. Unlucky. But holy shit, Dawnstar. Dawnstar barely even qualified to this tournament, and he is still holding strong. GG Fredwolf, though. Holy shit, what a race, though. The thing is, I said Skandir is gonna win this. He was my prediction. And look at this. Only one person with 2 lives. 3 with 3, and the rest all only has 1. So we are definitely gonna see people being knocked out on this map here. For sure. So let's see. Oh, Techie. One of the guys with 3 lives, not with the greatest start. Skandir going for an outside line, going for speed. Everybody making the jump here. Techie got it quite good. If he gets a good drift, he will be in. Yes, Techie looking good. And it is actually Dawnstar and Giuliano. Ain't no way. We lost 2 soldiers in 1 round already. Holy shit, eh. When will we have 1 knockout? After this map here. So we're only gonna have 1 more round where we where players will lose 2 lives, and the rest is gonna be 1 life only. So only the bottom player is gonna lose a life then. Oh wait, yeah, true. No, it's already this round because, yeah, it's a bit messed up. But it should technically be the next round. So only 1 KO now. 1 KO possible now. So who's gonna be? Skandir with a weak start, but he had a good ending before. So let's see if he can cook or if he cannot cook. Can he cook or will he get cooked? Oh, Marius. Marius, actually, good line. Is it Scandio losing his first life? I think it actually is Scandio. He is not unbeatable. That is the first life lost for Scandio. Holy moly. And that puts Lars and Techie into the best possible spot. And we go over to the next one. And it's called Dirty Talk. That's what I do with your mama most of the time. But it's also on a Trackmania map, actually. So let's see what people will do on this one. We could have knockouts now. Marius and Purple are the ones to watch out for. Elkon! My name is Elkon and I'm failing the press forward because I release in order to... Elkon release the first jump or try to go for a low jump to reduce airtime. This is exactly why I didn't put Elkon in first place. Like, Elkon is like the perfect candidate to do yek stuff like this. And I think he is easily out with that, but like easily losing life in this round. But this is such an Elkon thing to do. Well, the others all finishing without any major problems. Techie a little bit behind, but Techie is also still in. Yeah, that is actually Elkon being out because failing the press forward start. Unfortunate. With that, Elkon will go down to one life. Once again, a reminder that the top three of this tournament will win prizes worth around 400 euro combined, including Volvic packages and also big merch. So quite a lot of cool stuff on the line here. And we're not many positions away from that. And we still have Marius and Lars in, which is of course cool to see as the fellow OK boys. Oh! Uh-oh. I think Elkon is in the mud. Yo. GG Elkon. Elkon finishing in 6th place. And yeah. That was quicker than expected. Not gonna lie. The others can just save it through, of course. And yeah, Elkon actually in the mud. But yeah, GG nonetheless. 6th place is really, really good. So yeah. Hope to see you next month again, Elkon. No? And then top 3. Yeah. Of course. We need random track generator maps. This map was not built by anyone. It's basically randomly generated with an Open Planet plugin. You might already see this. It looks very dank and it also is very dank. It's actually very fucking shit. This is probably the worst map of the map pack, quality-wise. Because we have bobsleigh. And it's bobsleigh, first of all, with weird bumps. Then this part here is gonna be very funny because people are gonna jump down and they're gonna bump on this here and they could backflip. They will see it in the warm-up though. Well, look at this. Achtung. Bomb. So, 10 out of 10 map here. And then we have very cool effect blocks. We have no brakes and cruise control. And then we also have slow-mo and reactor boost. So absolutely high quality map. Gonna be great. So let's see what's gonna happen here. Does Techie know the map? Wait, what? Techie knows the map or what? I mean, that would be definitely a big advantage for him. Well, let's see. The start, nothing to worry about. The start is fine. Lars going for a release. Techie going for an ice slide. Interesting strategies. Techie, yeah, my name is Techie. Not with the greatest strat here, but at least he gets a clean landing. So he will actually have more speed than the others. Oh, actually, the clean landing was really good. Now going for this. No brakes and cruise control. So people will have very low speed here. And Techie actually has the lowest. Oh, Techie going for an ice slide. He got it really good. Lars overwalling! It is Lars, actually! Holy shit! Techie going for reactor up. Yeah, surely that was intended. He has zero speed. Is he gonna... Oh, he almost skipped the freewheel with that. But it is gonna be Lars, because he overwalled on this. Lars is gonna be out. Yeah, yeah. What can I say? Absolutely dog shit map. Wait. Oh my god, what did Techie do? Techie was so slow, but yeah, that respawn by Lars cost him solid 15 seconds. Actually, Techie is the only player now with 3 lives left. Who would have expected that? Who would have expected Techie to be the favorite to win this at some point? Crazy. Really great performance by Techie. Of course he's good on like Kaki and XTD maps, but he's also just safely... What did Purple do? Safely driving on the normal maps. So actually really good performance by Techie so far. So let's see what's gonna happen here now. It should be Purple in last. Yup. But yeah, 0.5 is not really making a big difference. So yeah, What is Techie usually playing? Like RPG, Trial, Kaki, that kind of stuff. Oh, purple with a bump and... Oh, that's gonna be really low speed. What, Techie having a lot of speed but clipping and he has an awkward line. He's going for a respawn. Actually, smart idea. What is he doing? Don't tell me he just... What the hell is Techie doing? Hello, guys! No, why did Purple respawn? Why did he respawn? He did a 15-second respawn for no reason. There is no way Techie is gonna survive. What the fuck is happening? What is happening? Nine! Ah! No! Purple, don't flip! Oh my god! And Purple is in! Holy shit, man, what the- Wait. Huh? Hallo? Finish? People? Hallo? Purple got second! What is happening? What the fuck happened? Like, I was like, oh my god, Purple, fourth place, barely in. I see him in the finish. Second. Mario's finishing 18 seconds ahead of second place. What the freaking fuck? Gonna make the last map three rounds, or we might loop back. Yeah, do that, John C. Do three rounds there. Yeah, high quality gaming here. I hope you all enjoyed that. But I think this is all we signed up for, right? Holy shit. Oh, I didn't do that when I tested this map. I can tell you I did not do this. Okay, it's press forward. Yeah, hello. I didn't notice that. I just went for like Giga XCD releasing and I was like, holy shit, this map is so bad. Oh, ain't no way. There is no way. There is a hole you jump into with the normal bobsled line and it has a million slow-mo blocks. Oh my god. Is this map full PF? I'm not sure. But the start at least is. And I think everybody also figured that out. Yeah, everybody's doing that. Okay, good focus. Yeah, okay. I'm pretty sure you could do this faster, but it's definitely the safest way to just do it like this. But yeah, who will fall into the hole? People are trying to steer away from it. Lars getting it really good. Some people bumping. Who is it? It is... Uh-oh. Scandia and Purple. Purple needs to survive, otherwise he's out. 9999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 We have a very dark part and everybody's crashing it. Nobody saw anything. Hello guys, my name is the Shadow Calculation. Yeah, fantastic. The thing is, literally everybody did the respawn, so it's actually pretty equal now again. What's coming up now? Oh, Scandia with low speed. Oh, wall right. You have to go really high. You have to go low. Did Scandia survive that? He did. Scandia sniped and it's Techie in last. Where's the finish? No, Marius not making the jump and Marius is out. No way. Holy shit. Marius didn't make the jump and barely missing out on the prizes. No, he didn't have enough speed for the speed check. Oh, holy shit. This map is mean. This map is hella mean. And with that, we have the top three set in stone. It is Scandia, Lars and Techie. They will all win something. But of course, it's still to be determined who's going to win what. So who's going to win the very first monthly final of the Big Yak Monthly Cup? We will find out very, very soon. People know the map now. I think it could be difficult for Techie now. But let's see. Who's my bet? My bet was Scandia all along. I predicted Scandia in first and Lars in second. Those were my predictions in my pick-ems. My other predictions are already out, so I didn't expect Techie to get top 5. So really sick performance by Techie. Honestly, most positive surprise this evening. So let's see. Oh, Lars is the only one understanding the line here, going inside nose light. The others lost quite a bit of speed here. Now we have the right turn coming into the dark part. Oh, Techie not really sure where he should drift on. We have grass here in the middle, by the way. And that could be the end for Scandia, unless he manages to get a sick wall ride and sniping someone. He is getting a low line. He is getting a lot of speed. But he is not getting this line down. Doing wicked flips. But it is actually Scandia being out. Third place for Scandia. With that, Scandia will win our current big jersey, which is looking mashallah, and also one Volvic package, including many different Volvic products. So GG to Scandia, very good performance nonetheless. A bit unlucky on certain maps, and ladies and gentlemen, the final is gonna be played out on a TMA full speed map. Isn't that amazing? I'm pretty sure Lars and Techie are very happy about that. A full speed competition map. I'm pretty sure they are in love. A map by entry lag. This is the final. Yeah, hello. Waypoint saved me, people say. Yep, this is a banger. This is a certified banger, guys. So, once again, a reminder. We are going to finish the tournament on this map. So, if necessary, we're going to have 3 rounds on this. So, let's see. Great start. Lars doing the Chem 7 strat. Techie rather deciding to go for a drive. The map is not too hard, to be honest. I tested it. I finished it first try with a solid time. It's not a hard full speed map. It should be fine. So yeah, let's see what people can do here. The final. Techie versus Lars. We're going in to round 1 out of a maximum of 3 rounds on this map. What's going to happen? Techie going for speed sliding. Having more speed with that than Lars. That could be the deciding key here. Lars may be trying to take it safe in order to, you know, not die. Both have 2 lives, by the way, so it is actually an even final. Oh, but this is not the greatest full speed lines, but Lars surviving while Techie is not. Oh my god, Lars barely saved that. And I think the finish should come up soon. Yep. And that is one advantage for Lars. The thing is, Techie now knows the map. And Techie was faster. So let's see. Good luck. Will we have a winner? Or will Techie beat Lars? It would be really cool if he would. For the story. For the story, I love to have a 1v1 final. In the final round. Techie. Oh my god. Techie had to interrupt his speed slide there. That looked very scary, but he is alive. That's of course very good. Going for an SD here. Lars also now speed sliding though. It's gonna come down to whoever is the better full speed player by the looks of it. And both of these are not good at full speed. Oh no, Techie had to overslide. Techie has less speed. Both speed sliding. Oh, Lars less speed! Techie sniping at the very last move and it is a 1v1 actually. Holy shit. Beating him by 0.1 because Lars had a small mistake. Good luck. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Who? Oh my god, final round. Tanky versus Lars. Both have one life. It will be decided in this one round. Both know the map now. Both, I'm pretty sure, will not do the mistakes. Who is gonna be better at speed sliding? Is it Tanky or is it Lars? Who is gonna win the very first Big Yak Monthly Cup? We'll find out in 30 seconds. Oh, Tanky not with the best start this time. Less speed than Lars. And also a bit of an awkward line. They both know that they have to speed slide, but they also both know that one crash basically decides everything. Oh, but this is looking very bad for Tanky. Looking very good for Lars, though. It is not that insane of a lead. Oh, but Tanky not with the greatest speed slide lines. I think this is pretty much set in stone. Yup, it is Lars with a very good last round, to be fair. A 37.5, 0.9, even beating the offer time. Closing it out, it is Lars winning the first Big Yak Monthly Cup. Very big GG to Scrappy as well, to Tanky as well though. Tanky in second, I definitely did not expect that. That is a really, really good performance by Tanky, really, really great. Lars was kind of expected to win this, and he pulled it off. So GG to Lars for, you know, living up to the expectations. And yeah, with that, the standings are set in stone, ladies and gentlemen. Tanky will basically win two of the Volvic packages as well as a big jersey. And Lars is gonna win a big tracksuit. So basically, you know, pants and jacket combined. A tracksuit, very good looking. As well as three of the Volvic packages. So yeah, GG to everybody who played. I really hope you enjoyed the very first monthly final of the Big Hack Monthly Cup. If you got any feedback, let me know on the Discord or maybe also in the YouTube comments. And yeah, I really hope you enjoyed watching this. I certainly did. It was really, really cool. So yeah, thanks a lot for playing and for watching. And yeah, GG guys. GG to all of you. Lars, interview. Lars, type 1. I want Lars to have an interview.
Hello.
Yeah, hello. Damn. Unexpected winner, Lars. Actually, guys, I didn't reveal the password to you guys.
How are you doing?
Very good. I quickly have to... Yeah, the password. Guys, the password for the server today was Lars only second in predictions, because I saw you also opened it on your stream that that in the predictions of the people, you were only... people only thought you would get second, and people thought
that... Yeah, honestly, really mad, guys. Why did you predict me on second place?
Hello? I expected Elkon to win, actually, but Elkon only got like 11.
I saw that password earlier and I was instantly like, fuck off, Granadi. I'm not saying what the password is, but fuck off.
Well, yeah, GG. Great performance overall, I would say. I think everything worked out for you, right? Like, were there any maps where you were like, oh my god, what the fuck?
Or did there was that one randomly generated map with the cruise control,
so
no brakes. Man, like, I was stuck in an ice slide and with no brakes and cruise control, I couldn't get out of it. I just slid out of the map. I couldn't do anything.
Yeah.
And then the second round, I grabbed Maximus up and flew out of the map as well, but somehow survived.
Dude, that second round, I don't know if you saw the gaps, but it was so chaotic. Marius won, and second place was 18 seconds behind.
Yeah, oh my god.
Yeah, it was
crazy.
Very, very fun to spectate.
Yeah, it was fun. Other than that, I think there was one round where I was orange, where I crashed, but other than that, every round was pretty safe, I think, for the most part.
Yeah, I had the same feeling. So how did you enjoy the format overall, the custom
Really fun format. I really liked the format. It was good timing as well. Like, it was really fun. I very much enjoyed it. Cool. Also, it worked very well on the server, and you could see the hearts on the left and stuff like that.
I'm very happy it did work out.
Yeah.
Okay, I have one final question, Lars, before I let you continue with your stuff. What were your thoughts when you went onto the final map and you saw it was a full speed map?
My thought was, I had to play 3 hours of full speed recently, and I said, at least now I never have to play full speed again. And then it's like, we have to play full speed.
Yeah.
The thing is, I wasn't happy about full speed, but I knew that Tanky wouldn't be happy about it either.
That's
so
true.
That
like, imagine you were in the final against Scrappy or Elkon or maybe even Kanchika or something.
Yeah,
the Matt would have been calling.
Yeah, Elkon would have been so hard to beat. He was so good on that other full speed map.
Yeah.
But yeah, like I felt like I had a decent chance against Tanky on full
speed.
It was very even,
to be honest.
Yeah, and in the second round was very close. I forgot one turn that I had to release at the very end.
Yeah, we saw that.
So
Tanky barely sniped. The thing is, in round one, Tanky was also faster and ahead, but he also had one small touch because he forgot a turn. So it was actually very even done. So it was very cool that we had the final with like two people only having one heart, and it was like all or nothing.
Yeah, it was really fun.
And yeah, hope you're gonna play next month again, Lars. No? Have to defend the title, of course.
Yeah, looking forward to it. It was really fun. I really enjoyed it.
Yeah, I also enjoyed spectating. It was really, really cool. Well, then, have fun in the rest of your stream. Thanks for playing. GG again. And
yo, GG.
Bye-bye.
Yo, see you. Bye-bye. Thanks for hosting.